Hello everyone and welcome back to Limpopo Conservation Park. And today we are going to build a meerkat habitat. Yeah, I know in the previous episode we talked about not having four rhino episodes after each other. I'm not sure if I actually mentioned what I was gonna do in the next video. But the plan was to start a savanna area. And you can see it in the back. I did start it with some fencing and some concrete buildings. But that's it. I didn't have much inspiration for it, but I did have a cool idea for a meerkat habitat. So that's what we're doing right now. As you can see, we are creating a little bridge. This is where the meerkats can cross the path and go to their other side of the habitat. So the habitat is going to be like two different sides. I thought it would be cool to have like a little tunnel. I saw it somewhere in one of the reference images I found on Zoolex or something like that. And this is a thing that they will actually have in a real zoo. So I thought, yeah, I can do that in this little area that we have left over here in Limpopo Conservation Park. So I see a lot of people joining the channel lately. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do. If you are enjoying this episode, make sure you also hit the like button. I know I normally don't really ask this in the beginning of the video, but yeah, let's try something else. Maybe people forget, you know, might happen. Who knows? Anyway, creating this beautiful wall. Yeah, with some beautiful aquatic rock pieces, as you can see, these little bricks. Trying to make them look as random as possible and also struggling with the pathing tool. I really regret that I didn't decide on like covering up the actual path, and sometimes it's a struggle. You have to redo stuff just because you can't do what you want with the pathing tool. Yeah, these little beautiful wooden trims on top of the wall. Yeah, not much going on actually in this episode. It's a very short episode comparing to the previous ones with all the rhino stuff, and this took me like 2-3 hours maybe to build. And yeah, normally like in the previous episodes, I almost had like 10 hours of footage, and so it's a bit different. I think only 12 minutes, something like that, and then some beautiful cinematics of this this little habitat. But yeah, it's a small animal, so I didn't want to build like a huge habitat for it. And I think that's one of the biggest struggles in the game right now, because we have these small animals, but we don't really have like really small items which would fit in this habitat. And I'm gonna make a shelter later on in the video, and the hitbox for the animals is just a little bit crap, to be honest, because I built quite a big hut for them to have shelter space, but they don't fit. The hitbox is completely off for the animals, but I was already expecting that, so my expectations weren't really high. But I'm still glad that we have the animals in the game. Of course, they look amazing. The animations are really good. The only thing they should fix is like a hitbox, and yeah, that would be really nice. Some detailing in the habitat itself. I put this little tent in. I thought it would look cool. Using the grass pieces, the enrichment item, the new one is really cool. The log, they can use it and it looks good. The new foliage is just amazing. I love it. I'm really happy that I can use it a lot in this new project. Some small rocks just for detailing on this side. And that's how easy you can make a meerkat habitat. You can see. Yeah, the bridge really important to have some kind of railing for the animals. Gonna use the glass pieces over here together with some wooden logs. Looks quite cool, to be honest. Normally they will use some kind of plastic perpex. I don't know, is that a word in English? I don't know. That's what they would normally use. Some nice trims here with the metal beams. And then you can see, oh, the animals could drop off here. But I don't think that the animals can actually escape from these sides, because it's too high. They won't drop down or anything. They are afraid of heights, apparently, meerkats. Not sure if you knew that. That's why they live underground, you know. Yeah. Yeah, on this side, basically the same thing. A little bit more... yeah, the terrain work. Nice little hill they can climb. And it's actually really cool. In the end, you will see it, that the guests will have like a view of the animals on eye level. So normally they would sit on top of this little hill. And in-game, they actually do this. Yeah, it's really cool. A really nice view for the guests on the animals over here for this little habitat. Trying to make this rock work look a little bit more interesting instead of just dropping down some of these big flat rocks. It comes out really nice. Combining it with the normal desert and savanna rocks, and it looks cool. Looks cool. So here we go with the shelter space I was talking about. I actually created an entire building. I did that 2 or 3 times. Wasn't happy with it, and then I decided to make like a little African hut, but just for the animals, so the keepers can't really reach into it. They can clean it, but they can't sit in it or whatever. And over here, using a little trick with the grid to make sure you have the perfect circle. So if you copy this over, then you can make this perfect circle. I'm leaving a little bit of open space because this is a hot area. So yeah, we can't really have air conditioning inside this thing. So making sure that the wind can blow through, making it look a little bit more random, you know, moving around some pieces and creating some different colors on it. Just to make it look a little bit better. And yeah, it needs a floor as well. Using the art shapes. Normally don't really use the art shapes. But it fits perfectly. And the plaster pieces were too big. Yeah, unfortunately. And you can see that the hut is a little bit too high at the moment, I think. So I'm fixing that. Oh, I'm already fixing that. How wonderful is that? Putting it in the corner, it looks quite cool. I think it's nice. It's one of the smaller thatch roofs that I used, and I think it fits. But the animals can't get in, unfortunately. No. So when I upload this one to the Steam Workshop, you will have to figure out some shelter space somehow, because this is a sandbox, so I don't really care about that. Because in my mind it works, and in real life it would work, but in game it doesn't. So I'm not gonna fix that. I tried it. But I had to redo the entire hut, make it way too big, and that's not what I wanted. So that's why it's gonna look like this, and it's not gonna work in game, unfortunately. Maybe one day they will fit the hitbox, and then that's gonna work out. The rocks here making it look a little bit random, making it look like it's broken down a little bit. And we're gonna continue the wall on this side. Redoing it once in a while, making sure it's not too repetitive. I do get a lot of comments about that, you know, fencing too repetitive, walls too repetitive, whatsoever. So I'm trying to improve that a little bit. And that's what we're doing. The rocks, the color of the rocks, it doesn't save it. It's really annoying. So every time I have to copy it from the other side, otherwise I have to put the color code back in. And that was annoying. Trying different stuff over here. You can maybe even see it. I only speed it up 7 times. Normally with Limpopo I did 8 times. With Veluwezoo I did 7 times. So let me know down in the comments if this speed is a little bit better for you to follow along, or to, don't get... Sometimes I see some videos that people speed up their footage like 12 times. And it's just way too much. I can't follow it. And the camera work is horrible. So I try to make sure that is looking fine. So let me know down in the comments if you see the difference. Yes, no. If you like it, yes or no. If you don't care, yes or no. You can all leave it down in the comments. And we're creating this beautiful corner over here. I made it a little bit too tight. So yeah, redoing it. Wooden trims. Be placing them everywhere. I really like the look of it. It's modern, but still it looks like it fits over here. With the rocks, with the bricks. Yeah. I'm not sure if it's like super realistic that they don't really have an indoor area. I'm not sure if anyone has like a lot of knowledge about meerkats in the zoo. Let me know if that is a thing. They really need like a big indoor area, maybe where they can separate them, or maybe they can just catch them and keep them somewhere else so I can build it, I don't know, in like the backstage area of the rhino thing. That we did in episode number 2, like next to the Fennec Fox. Maybe I can create something over there. They can keep them separately. Maybe some nice cages, something like that. But yeah, let me know if you have like a huge knowledge about meerkats. Maybe you keep them at home. Who knows? Is that a thing? Who knows? I don't care. If you have meerkats, that would be cool. Oh, see, the animals are in. I put like 16 of them. I think you can put like hundreds of them in one habitat. But they make a big mess, so you have to clean it all the time. So we don't want that nice little big tree. Little big tree. Yeah, it's not too big. It's also not little. So a little big tree over here. Again, these rocks, of course, I love them. Making some color variations. Not sure about them yet. I think the gray is a little bit off, but we'll see. We'll see. Terrain work. Yeah, making sure it looks a little bit more interesting. Checking the path, making sure it fits. And then some nice, wonderful foliage inside, some rocks, all the detailing everywhere. Yeah, this area is coming along nicely, if you ask me. You can see it in the end, probably, with the cinematic shots. It's pretty nice. And yeah, some lighting over here. And then we reached the end of this video. So I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do, so you won't miss out on anything new. And I'm gonna speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye. Yu-Yu.